So, pretty sure you're supposed to kill that before you cook it there, Leroy.
No, 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 Steven. What you don't understand is that these squirrels be like lobsters. They can't feel shit. They ain't got no big spinal columns like you and me.
I don't think that's how pain works.
Look here, String Bean. Either you want to eat or you don't. Last I heard, you ain't eating no meal in a couple days.
Yeah, I mean, I usually prefer my meals to be a little more skinned than that, but beggars can't be choosers.
Wait just a goddamn second. You said you weren't no beggar. You were one of them temporarily homeless.
It's an expression, Leroy.
And I just done expressed it to you. Look here, where you going, Steven? Don't be choking the chicken too long.
I have to go to piss, man. I'll be right back.
Well, this squirrel's almost ready to be eaten. Now I'm gonna wait for your ass.
It's mid-April 2015. I'm still homeless. I've found about enough money in the fountains around here to get a refill on my medication, but hoping I'll be able to make a return to society soon enough and more respectable meals.
You talking to yourself again?
Well, you know, I didn't really expect to be here after losing my job and getting kicked out of my apartment, but, well, beggars can't... You know the line.
Steven, you can only masturbate so much! Little more meat left on the bone, Steven. Dig on in.
Why not?
Thanks.
Fire could use some more wood.
What say you? We throw your goddamn tent in the fire.
I don't know about it. People drive by all day, pass me, passing by, but, you know, no one bothers to stop and help me out, but, you know, whatever, it's cool. I mean, I'm pretty sure I stopped and gave some homeless guy money once back when I was doing well off, but, you know, whatever. You know, fuck these pricks. You know, it's not like I'm so lazy that I don't want a job. I mean, I had a job. I just, everything went bad for me all at the same time and I lost it. Like, would I do things differently now? Probably.
Now you see here, Steven, the rookie mistake is to ambush the guy while he's walking towards his car and steal all the loot he found.
What are you talking about robbing a guy, man? I just came to the park to enjoy the park. What?
Now I got a plan, Steven. I got a goddamn plan. So I'm going to try to distractify the guy, but have him take a picture of me. You're going to sneak up behind him and try to steal his metal detectorino, then run for the hills.
Leroy, that's a weed whacker. That's not even a metal detector.
That ain't a weed whacker. That's a weed whacker and a metal detectorino in one. It's a fully fine-tuned old machine.
Wouldn't it be a lot easier to go to some dude's house when he's at work and just take it from his yard?
Where's your sense of adventure, Steven? Live a little, my man.
Okay, your plan here. How are you going to get him to take your picture? You don't have a camera.
But I'm sure he does.
Why would he take a picture of you with his camera?
Just remember the plan, Steven. Don't be a coward like the other temporarily homeless folk.
You know, one would assume that myself or any homeless man for that matter would have the good sense to move to a big city or a warmer climate. But then again, if you had good sense, you probably wouldn't be homeless, right?
Hey, sir. Hey, sir, please take a picture of
me? No.
Why can't you take a picture?
Why would I take a picture of you?
Get out of here. Steven, get a move on. He's probably already calling the cops.
Can't believe you did that. You know, it was really nice of you not to take his phone. It was probably worth more than that piece of crap.
Damn. It's a good idea, Steven. If you were with me, you could have told me that. But now it's too late, man. We got to get a move on. We're going to meet at the meeting point.
The rendezvous.
I assume that's a curse word. And if it was, I agree.
Wow. Leroy is definitely not the positive influence I needed in my life right now. I don't think I'm ready to embrace this fully homeless lifestyle right now.
I thought that was you.
It's Aaron, bud. Yeah, I thought you moved out west.
You don't want to know what I thought about you. Hey, come on in. Let's catch up. Let me clean this.
No, I got the bag.
All right. Come on in.
Yeah, so I guess the best advice I can give you is never trust anyone that compares lobster to squirrel.
That is insane, man. Like, this whole story, I mean, I remember when we were in middle school, you said that your dream was to someday be a bum in a big city. I mean, this isn't a big city, but I mean, like, oh, man. I think you even wrote that in the yearbook. We had some good laughs back then.
Yeah, I know. You're still laughing now.
Yeah, I am. I'm sorry. That's rude. It's this thing where, like, I can't display the right emotion, so I just laugh at inappropriate times.
Oh, like at your mom's funeral.
Yeah. Just like that. You know, Steven, let me help you out with the food portion of that, all right?
Oh, I mean, food's good and all, but I really need to get my prescription filled.
That's what that is. All right, Steven, you really need to consider context when you're writing out those signs. Let's go down to the pharmacy, all right?
I mean, drugs are drugs. A pharmacy's a drugstore, right?
So, you know what's gayer than two men sitting at a picnic table, eating hot dogs together?
I can think of a few things.
That was the joke.
What was the joke?
That was the joke.
Alright, Steven. No more jokes until you get a little bit more nourished. The part of your brain that with humor in it is a little hungry right now. Right, guy?
Oh, thanks. So, what brings you back northeast? Man, I haven't seen you in a while.
Work, mostly. I've been with my company for a while. They got me to move out here. And my girlfriend and I, we survived the long-term, long-distance thing. And I got her to come out here, so it's going pretty good.
Girlfriend or fiance? I see you got a ring.
Yeah, well, the ring, you know, it's nothing to do with her. It's something my parents gave me.
Okay. So how long you two been together?
I would talk with my mouth full. Something she taught me.
Classy.
Right, yeah, you know, we've been together long enough. Most of the time we've been together is me trying to get her to come here.
Well, I mean, with any woman, it takes a while to have them come, no matter where you are.
Steven, no more jokes. Lay off them.
You liked that one.
All right, so tell me again, why'd they fire you from the lawn care job? All right. Forget I asked.
You know, dude, it just pisses me off that they fired me like that. You know, they didn't bother to hear my side of the story. Dicks. I mean, guy calls and just says I left a gate open and his fucking dog got out.
They let you go just like that?
Yeah, I mean, I spent the next few days trying to look for that damn thing.
The dog?
Yeah, some boxer fucking named Fenway.
I have a friend with a cat with the same name.
We all have friends that have cats with really stupid names. Everyone names their cat something stupid.
Okay.
It's the go-to thing.
So was this before or after you got kicked out of your place?
Man, that might as well have been the same time.
Oh, shit. Got some advice for you, my friend. Don't buy a lottery ticket anytime soon. But, no, Steven, seriously, though, I have a feeling your luck's about to change, all right? Just give me a second. I'll be right back.
So it's mid to late April? I don't know the actual date. Don't have a calendar in front of me. Oh, well. Figure it out one of these days. It's probably the most real meal I've had in quite a while now. Months, it feels like. I don't know if my body can handle these actual food portions. Probably gonna get some nasty gas later, but can't really smell worse than I already do. Met up with an old friend today from my childhood, by chance. Darren. If anything, he scares me a lot less than Leroy. That's for sure.
What was that, Steven?
Huh?
Sorry, I thought you were saying something.
No, nothing.
Alright, so I was just talking with Elise. And we'd like to have you over for dinner tonight, you know, maybe. And you can use the shower, too, clean up a little bit.
Yeah, man, I don't want to put you out like that.
Put me out? Come on. It's nothing, I promise.
Dude, I don't even go to homeless shelters, man. Like, I've still got some pride.
All right, Steven, I saw you on the side of the road with a sign. And I figured your pride would have gone away long before a homeless shelter, if you're doing that.
Oh, excuse me. How selfish of me. Let's do all the things you want to do.
And it was better when Jim Carrey did it, but, you know, I appreciate the reference. And, Steven, let's, I gotta go to the barbershop anyways. Come with me, and then I'm going home and have some dinner.
So you remember that joke I said about eating hot dogs and how that was gay?
Yeah.
Now we're going to the barbershop.
Well, we won't have the hot dogs there. We'll finish those before we get there.
You're giving me a whole skit here, kid.
Steven, come on in. Don't mind the mess. Meet the one responsible for it, Elise.
Hey, thanks for having me.
So, who's ready to eat?
We're eating?
I'm not happy with my life. I know it's immoral and it's not the right way to be, but nothing seems to work. And then I thought we could eat when we got here. And as he says, you can change your mind.
Change your body.
He's the teacher.
Sorry,
I'll have a shower. Come help me.
Hey, Steven, here, let's go over this way. All right, here, the bathroom's right over this way. Feel free to take a shower. I'll grab you some clothes that you can wear, and Lisa and I will get dinner ready. Feel free to use my loofah while you're in there.
Saturday, April 24th, approximately 6 p.m. It's gonna take a couple showers to get this stank off me, but it's okay. I need to shed her later through the smell. Darren's girlfriend out there, Elise, does not seem very thrilled for me to be here, but I can't blame her. Who wants a dirty, smelly hobo in their house showering? But I'm more than thrilled. I have not been at a table to eat a real meal in ages.
All right, Steven, dinner's just about ready. Oh, yeah, we'll be eating out here. We normally just eat in the living room. Kitchen table's kind of just for stuff. So back in high school, this guy perfected the way to cheat on vocab tests. So our test was after lunch, so we always had these little bags of chips left over from lunch. And what he would do is he'd write the vocab words on a little tiny piece of paper. He'd put it in his bag of chips, and with the teacher looking right at him, he would reach in, grab a chip and one of the little slips, take a look at it, study it, chew on it, swallow both of them, write down the answer, get an A+. I might not have passed high school if it wasn't for this guy.
Yeah, you know, I don't think I remember even a single word we learned in that class.
Right, it's useless. I mean, it kind of like pre-calc. You don't need that stuff to get ahead in... What is that? Hey, what are we watching?
Well, actually, you know what? I do remember one word. Niggardly. Why on earth would they have us learn such a racist-sounding word?
I don't know, maybe the people who wrote the curriculum are from down south.
Down south? Why do you gotta be down south to be racist? There's plenty of racist people around here.
That's true. You did single out that word to remember.
Hey, if that makes you racist, then I guess I'm just as bad as the rest of them.
Yeah, I guess so.
By the way, this spaghetti, fucking awesome.
Oh, don't thank me.
We have Elise to thank for that.
Okay, well then, thank you, Elise. Quality spaghetti.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, by the way, I don't think I mentioned this before, but Elise here, she went to culinary school.
Yeah?
For one semester. Usually leaves that part out.
Well, what happened?
Life.
Yeah, I guess I can relate to that given, you know, my circumstances.
So, what's the deal with that, if you don't mind me asking? I mean, don't you have some family that you could live with?
I have parents, but they moved down to Florida to an old folks' home, and they wouldn't have any room for me.
Yeah, they're getting pretty old, and they're healthy, but, you know, they're older.
Yeah.
So, they won't even help you out financially or anything?
No, it's not that. It's just our relationship's complicated.
Yeah, they never really got along.
My number?
Well, I mean...
No.
It would just disappoint them so much or give them a stroke if I contacted them, or even worse, it would give them vindication that I'm such a screw-up.
Yeah, I think that was one of our vocab words.
You know, I think the story's better if the only word I remember is niggardly.
Steven, define better.
So wait. You'd rather be homeless than embarrass your parents?
I'm only temporarily homeless.
I mean, have you even looked for jobs?
Christ, will you let the man eat his damn food? I brought him here so he doesn't need to think about that stuff for just a little bit of time. Alright, Steven, remember that time in middle school when you accidentally threw your retainer in the trash can?
And I dumped out the trash and found it? Awesome. But, I've put in an application to a few places here and there, but it's really tough without access to a phone or a computer. Should I...
Yeah, just throw that in the sink. I'll take care of it later.
Thanks.
Those new layers.
Went in the deep, dark woods with its long.
Oh, same day. Later on.
I don't know. This doesn't seem that good idea.
He's a good guy. He just needs our help, is all. It's not like he's gonna be putting us out all that much.
I don't know. You haven't seen him in years. People change.
He's a good guy. Dark. I mean, he'll be in the basement. He'll be out of the way. He won't even notice that he's here.
Do I even have a seance?
Don't say it like that. Hey, Steven. Hey, let's go to the kitchen for a second and have a little chat.
Same day. Later in the evening. I mean, this couch is horrendous. The ground outside had to have been better for my back than this piece of shit. But, you know, whatever. I'll make it work. Darren said I can use his computer tomorrow to fill out a bunch of applications, so it's looking like I'll spend the better part of the day doing that.
Are you sure you can't make it? I mean, no, I know. It's just it's a big game today. We need you, Mac. No. Yes, I know you need to be with your family. Yeah? No. All right. You do what you gotta do. We'll make it work. I'll let you know how we do. All right, good luck, buddy. Fucking piece of shit. Fuck!
Guy.
All right. Steven. You don't have anything going on today, do you? All right. Dumb question. All right, so, turns out the goalie for our roller hockey team can't make it today. You want to fill in, suit up?
I don't know. Why can't the other guy make it?
All right, well, like, here's the deal. His cat died or some shit like that, so. It's a dumb excuse, I know.
That fucking cat Fenway?
Yeah, that's the one.
Good.
Good?
Fuck that cat, dude. Whatever. Look, I haven't played much hockey. Air hockey, I guess, but...
All right, that's close enough, all right?
Okay.
All right, so really, we just need a body, because if we don't have enough people, then we need to forfeit for the playoffs. So we just need you to be there. And if you win, that's gravy. That's gravy.
I mean... Yeah, okay.
Fine. Yes! All right. Let's go change, buddy.
Darren, this gear smells like an actual pile of shit that's been fermenting in a locker room. Like, how do you wear this, man?
Sounds about right. Well, look at it this way. If I don't win anything else today, I'll win worse smell.
All right, whatever, man. So, is there anything I need to know before we get started here?
Not really. I'll warm you up. We'll go out there. I'll get you ready. The only thing you need to watch out for is that guy right there.
Kevin Bonneville, best player in the league.
Oh, great. Now I got to play against him.
Don't worry. We'll shadow him. We won't give him any chances on you, all right?
I hope so. So, who's that guy with the papers?
It's Moo McNeil. He's the prick who runs this league.
So what makes him a prick? Just the fact that his name's Moo?
No, his name's not actually Moo. It's like Marky or something. He used to milk cows, so everyone just calls him Moo. But no, the thing that makes him a prick is that he always changes the rules around just to fit his team's needs.
Hang on, so the guy that runs the league also plays in it?
Not only does he play in it, but as commissioner, like, he stacks his team, and he always makes it so he wins in the playoffs. For example, last year, he suspended some players for posting stuff in a message board that was conduct detrimental to the league.
Are you fucking kidding me?
And his butt buddy Ivan over there, that he's always on his team too.
Well, I mean, he can't stack his team too well, I guess, if Bonneville doesn't play for him.
Alright, Bonneville's not on his team today. Just wait until playoffs. Things will be different.
Alright, well, I mean, what do you even get for winning?
This trophy that they bought. He spent like $500 on the trophy and made everyone pay for it.
Who's that guy?
That guy, that's Ivan, the guy I was talking about earlier. That's not his real name. I don't think I know his real name.
The fuck's he pointing at? Hey, Darren!
Hey.
Getting ready for the game?
Yeah, Moo, it looks like it'll be a good one.
Yeah, definitely, definitely. What happened to Mac?
Mac wasn't able to make it due to a death in the family, but luckily my friend Steven is filling in for us.
Nice to meet you, Steven.
Pleasure.
Sure.
So, I think it's your buddy. Yeah, I'm sure he's a great guy and all, but, per league rules, you know, it's not okay to just bring another non-league player in without getting their team captain permission first.
Right, and I did talk to the captain from the other team. He said it's all right, so we're good.
All right. Let it slide this time. Next time, you gotta let me know first, okay?
Sure.
Okay. We don't want to jeopardize the integrity of this league.
You got it, Moo.
Okay. All right, now I gotta go remind him of the league's protocols.
Yep.
Good luck out there, Steven. Fuck that guy.
Yeah.
All right. Don't worry about it. Yeah. Let's go warm up.
Here you go.
Dude, I'm not putting this fucking puke bucket on my head.
Like you have to wear a helmet.
Does it say that in Moo's little rule book?
No. I don't think it does. I mean, it will after today. But if you want to go out there and potentially get hurt, just don't bitch at me. All right.
I'll take it. I'll take the risk.
Yes. All right. Let's go.
So if you had told me a week ago, or hell, even as soon as yesterday, that I'd be standing here wearing this stinky-ass gear playing goalie for Darren, I'd have laughed right in your stupid face. But, well, here I am. So I can't really say I'll be too disappointed if I don't.
Alright, Steven, don't worry about it. It was a fluke goal. It happens. I just shake it off and focus on the game.
I got it, man. I'll get into it.
Alright, it's all mental.
Alright.
Alright, got this. Darren's sake, settle in here.
Alright, Steven, don't worry about it. You're trying, that's all I can really ask. You're obviously not a goalie, but this obviously isn't a good defense for you right now.
Yeah, no, they don't help you too much, so.
Have some water, shake it off, and you're alright.
The hell?
What was that?
Just drinking my water. There's a little timeout, right?
So it's not a timeout, you have to call timeout first.
The ref always checked to see if I was right at every other face-off. He didn't do it this time.
Good point. Moo, what's up with that? Our goalie wasn't even ready.
So?
So the ref always checks to see if the goalie's ready.
So? He didn't call a timeout or anything?
Yes, I'm familiar with timeout rules in your little rulebook here, but I mean, our goalie was drinking water for crying out loud.
Darren, I don't think there's anything about drinking water in the rulebook. Do you say anything like that, Ivan?
Can't say I do.
Are you kidding me?
Sorry, Darren. I'll agree, the referees do normally do stuff like that, but
more of a courtesy, not a requirement.
This is bullshit.
Take a seat, Darren. That'll be a minor penalty for abuse of officials.
Are you for real right now?
Anything further will be a game misconduct and warrant a review for further discipline.
Well, that's her, Jake.
All right, Steven, they're on the power play. Sit down the fort until time expires, all right?
So no one else wants to play goalie? All right. Made a save. I guess one out of four is not bad, 25%. Take it.
All right, he's coming in on a breakaway. Be aggressive with your stick. Attack.
What the hell?
Whoa, whoa, Steven, stop. Steven!
You know, I should have the cops called on you. You could have killed Bonneville.
This is hockey, right?
Yes, exactly. This is hockey, not a goddamn musket fight.
A musket fight?
Look, I won the state championship in high school, okay? I've seen a lot of hockey. Never have I ever seen anything like that.
All right, well, Steven hasn't seen a lot of hockey.
And you. I heard you telling him to attack with a stick.
Oh, come on.
Did you or did you not tell him to attack with a stick?
You damn well know the context.
Ivan, note Darren's tone. That'll be a one-game suspension for abusive official.
You've been warned.
Context or not, you brought in a wild card and encouraged him to act out aggressively. We simply cannot have that, Darren. Steven will be suspended indefinitely, and you'll be on probation throughout the remainder of the season.
Look, man, you don't have to be such a dick about it. It's a little fucking roller hockey league.
I'm being pretty lenient. Normally under these conditions, team Don't Puck With Me would be ineligible for the playoffs. But due to extenuating circumstances, I'm not going to enforce that rule.
I don't think I'd be that lenient.
Oh, thank you, oh great commissioner, for letting us play in the playoffs. We're so grateful.
Get him out of here before I change my mind.
All right, come on. All right, Steven, let's go. Let's go.
I think I've seen that Steven guy around somewhere before.
As long as we don't have to see him again.
Rough game?
Hey, you didn't update your calendar.
Yeah.
Huh?
Rough game.
Typical.
So you're writing something? Okay, dumb question. What are you writing?
One of my friends is a comedian, and he does shows in places across the country. Sometimes I write jokes for him, and if he uses them, I get a pretty generous check.
Oh, right on. What's his name?
I doubt you've heard of him.
Well, what's his name?
Elron.
Oh, so is he one of those one-namer kind of deals?
No, his last name is Hubbard.
Elron Hubbard. Like, L. Ron Hubbard, the Scientologist? Is that supposed to be like a play on words for his comedian stand-up thing?
I don't know. Maybe.
Well, does he ever talk about Scientology?
Subjects never come up.
Yeah, well, if he never actually talks about Scientology, I doubt he's actually a Scientologist, and it's just for the comic relief.
Good point. Darren! Darren! Your phone's ringing!
I definitely don't miss that.
Miss what?
Being tied down to a phone and having people be able to reach you 24/7. Life's just so much easier when you can't be reached.
I definitely can't relate.
Yeah, most people can't. I don't play by society's rules. I guess that's why I got the boot.
Yeah. Hey, Darren. Someone called you. I think that they left a message.
Tell me one of those jokes.
One of these jokes?
Yeah, well, I mean, if a touring comedian uses your stuff, it must be worth sharing.
I don't know. I write him in his voice, so I don't think I can deliver it with the same gusto.
Give it a shot.
Okay. What's Bruce Lee's favorite drink? Water!
Yeah, I think I would have to hear him deliver it.
Yeah.
So, is he like a joke-telling kind of comedian, or is he more of like a observational, funny guy?
A little bit of both.
Okay, well, let's try another one.
Okay, so a child predator and a boy are walking in the woods, and the boy looks at the man and says, "Boy, it's spooky out here." The man says, "You're telling me. I gotta walk out of here all by myself."
Oh, that's a lot darker, but funnier in a molesty sort of way.
Yeah, people like rape jokes.
I got a call in the office, some server migration issue.
Are you going to be back in time to go to the movies?
Yeah, probably not. We'll have to go later on in the week. We'll get to it.
Well, hey, do you want me to do anything around the house while you're gone?
That's not necessary. Just fill out some new applications and follow up on the ones that you already filled out.
Okay, I can handle that.
And Elise, I'll text you. I'm on my way back.
All right, have fun.
We love you, Pinky. Hey, what movie were you going to watch?
That new Boo for Sci film. I don't think it's something Darren actually ever wants to watch.
Who wouldn't want to watch that? Pazow!
Hey, at least that's a reaction.
I mean, if you don't want to go alone, I'd watch it with you.
I'll tell you what, if you help me with the dishes, I'll spot you a few bucks.
So I liked how tasteful that sex scene was.
Sex scene?
Yeah, where the guy threw all the feathers into the air.
Oh, you mean the rape scene.
Well, I guess it wasn't that tasteful then, huh?
No, that's why we left 30 minutes into the film.
Oh, I thought we left because you didn't like the popcorn.
You didn't even get any popcorn.
Yeah, because I thought you didn't like it.
Are you fucking with me right now?
Hey, Elise, what's going on?
Hey! Not too much, just the usual.
I hear you. Who's this with you? I haven't met this one yet.
Oh, this is Steven, Darren's friend from high school. They just recently reconnected.
Okay, nice to meet you, Steven. I'm assuming we're having the usual?
Absolutely. Look at you.
Did you? He made that before we came over here. Didn't he move here just a few weeks ago? How do you know?
It doesn't take me long to figure out what people like. You're a Jack and Colt type of guy, right?
You're good.
Before you make up your mind, I'm actually running some specials tonight on some house trees I've been working on. Two for the price of one.
Okay, what are they?
Disgusting.
It's actually a little mix I've been putting together. I just need to find the right food to go with it. I haven't found one yet, but I'll get there. Tonight, I'm actually taste testing Granny Smith apples for one drink and Clementine for the other.
Yeah, you know, you pegged me pretty good with the Jack and Coke. I'm a little light in the wallet anyway.
You know what? You have to have a wallet for it to be light. So he'll take the Jack and Coke and the house specials, just put it on my tab. He's had a hard time lately.
Coming right up.
You don't have to buy me a drink.
I'm going to tell you what I tell everybody else. I spend my fun money exactly how I want to spend it.
Oh, so you want to buy me a drink?
Hey, don't twist my words. So there I am, on my hands and knees, in my bra and underwear, shoveling cereal into my mouth as fast as I can. So fucking embarrassing.
Never would I have imagined any story topping me getting hit on by the milkman, but that just may have done it.
What? What's wrong?
It's that hockey showboater from earlier.
What?
Not that I'm worried about him or anything, it's just I don't want to deal with any of that hockey bullshit right now.
Hey.
Want some more of those house drinks?
Fuck no.
What about you? What you think?
I think it'd be better with cantaloupe or watermelon. It's not really doing it for me.
Not a bad idea.
I didn't call you over here to talk about those drinks.
Well, you already have my phone number, so I know it's not that.
No. You see that guy over there?
Yeah, were you trying to ask him out?
No! But look what they did to my friend here! Bandages don't grow naturally out of human skin. They fucked him up.
Has it given you any trouble since you got here?
No, they've been over here. We're over here. What? I want to keep
them. No, fuck that. Hey, mother dick! What's your deal? Are you ready to take your sorry
sack? Hey! Look, you're a little too intoxicated. You're saying things maybe that you shouldn't say. It looks like you're trying to start a brawl. We're not gonna have that, at least not to someone else's ship.
Did you see what they did to my friend?
Look, it's probably better you should just go.
Yeah, I think that's a good idea.
Come on.
Did she just say mother dick to you?
Yeah, apparently.
What the?
Hey, thanks again for the night out. I really needed that.
Nah, no problem. I figured you'd like that more than filling out applications online.
Definitely. Hey, let me ask you a question. What did that bartender mean earlier when he said that I had never met this guy?
I mean, I think exactly what he said. He's never met you before. Kind of surprising considering you've been in town for so long.
But what did he mean specifically by this one?
I don't know. He's never met me before. He says a lot of weird things.
What was his name again?
Good question. I don't really know. I never asked. Not that important.
Yes. Red light, red light!
God. For someone with nothing to lose, you sure worry about it.
Hey, I never said that I have nothing to lose.
I guess I made an assumption. You know what making assumptions does?
Yeah, you're right.
You know, I gotta ask you something. What is your end game? Like, what are you planning to do? What are you doing?
You know, I've honestly been asking myself that. I'm not aimless. I know what I have to do to fit in into society and, you know, all the skills that it takes and stuff, but it's just not me.
So until then, you're just a homeless person without drive?
Yeah, I don't know. I guess I'll just have to figure that out.
Well, then, I'm gonna do you a favor and ask you again. What are you doing here? Oh my god, that was so funny! Oh my god, I hope Darren's not too bad and we're out. Again?
Woo! Woo!
We're so stupid. Thank you. Hey!
Oh, hey. You guys are alive. Thanks for calling.
If you were that worried, you should have called or texted.
No, you should have called me.
Did you rearrange things in here?
You got a job yet, Steven?
It's been a day and a half. Sunday.
Yeah, well, fill any applications?
I filled one out at the movie theater.
That's Walter White.
Walter Jr.
Wait, so you guys went to the movies without me?
It's something you wouldn't even like.
That's not the point.
But look, you're noticeably upset, Darren. I don't know if it's because we did something, or if it's because these 12-year-olds are kicking your butt on this game. But either way, I think I'm gonna head downstairs and go to bed.
Yeah, I think that's a good idea.
Well, good night.
Good night, guys.
No, Jamie, I'm not talking to you.
Same day, later on. Now that I've been given a second chance, I feel less sure of what I want to do. I mean, I'm not tied down to anyone or anything. I can go wherever I want, but it's just like, when I'm here at Darren's, I feel like I gotta be so much more precise with everything I say, and like, more so than being out in the woods, where I can go wherever I want and jizz on whatever I feel like, you know? I mean, God. I feel like I can't even get away with saying the word jizz around other people without them freaking out or something. I don't know. I think I think I'm just going to leave in the middle of the night and be gone. And I don't know. I don't know what I need, but I know I don't need their help.
Well, well, well. Look what we have here. I thought you was eaten by a bear or something. You ain't no man. You ain't roughing it. You're just a victim to the world's ails and woes, ain't ya? You're just addicted to them washing machines, them fondue fountains, and them picture boxes, and...
And yet, here I am.
Yeah, here you are. For now. Steven, let me introduce you to Clark here, who's become twice the hobo as you in half the time.
No, I didn't really notice it was a competition, but sure.
Well, it is. Don't touch his hand! You don't know where his hand's been, all them chemicals he's been touching. Best for us to keep our distance.
Okay. Nice to meet you.
Clark here is what them laymen call monosyllabic.
What did you mean by that?
Means all of his words are short and sweet.
No. What did you mean by keep your distance and I'm, like, disgusting? Am I being shunned for visiting society?
You're not one of us, Steven. That day with the metal detectorino really showed your true colors.
That was 2 days ago.
Exactly. 2 days ago. You were a coward then, and you're a coward now. Clark here, he's got guts. He stayed up all night with that metal detectorino looking up precious metals.
Found a bunch of coins and stuff. You realize your metal detector is a weed whacker. It's got string on it, man. How are you finding coins with a weed whacker?
You leave that to us, Mr. Clean. I'm a nice guy. I'm gonna give you a second chance. Are you ready to embrace the lifestyle of the permanently homeless?
Well, are you? You're all selling stuff. Alright guys, so got $15.
That's
that
it?
Weed whacker.
That's all you got? Could've had someone cop that shit for double the amount.
Well then maybe you should've done that.
Nah, this'll do. Here's your share, Clark. That's your share, this is the rest is mine.
Well, I don't get any?
Nah, me and Clark, we determined that you'd probably keep the money for yourself.
What, you think I got more money for that piece of crap than $15?
How about you show us that wallet you love carrying around?
My wallet?
Yeah, your wallet. Let's see how many bills are lying around in there.
Well, it's not empty.
Aha! You admit to your burglarizing ways. You wouldn't help me get the metal detectorino and get some precious metals, but you're so happy about stealing money from me and Clark.
Are you serious? Okay.
Get the fuck out of here.
Go. Leave us be, bitch.
April's turned into May, and I'm afraid my darkest days are still ahead. I've been out in this shit wilderness long enough to know that it's not for me. Not that residential life's for me either, but this is even less so. You know, there are days when I feel like I'm beginning to figure it out. You know, where I'm going, what I'm doing, where I belong. But, you know, those days are always just followed by long, cold nights of doubt and isolation. It's not really so much that being homeless bothers me, you know, we're all homeless in a way, but it's just that the problem is we recognize when somebody else doesn't have four fucking walls to keep them warm.
Oh, yeah. Well, no rain cover, but thanks, Darren.
You know, I don't think I'm so much a victim of my choices as I am circumstances out of my control.
My harmonica skills aren't as good, though.
No, you're really good.
Thanks. Wanna go practice somewhere? Out on the street?
Yeah.
Made a friend.
Maybe I could have handled things differently to not end up this way. You know, but I know I shouldn't be focusing on the past so much. The past is dead. What's done is done, and that's it.
Rip, come on. But
you know, but old habits die hard. As much as I want to remove myself from this situation and that situation, I just can't do it. Maybe I shouldn't have left the way I did. That's something I'm just gonna have to live with.
Yeah, so one of these days I'm gonna get what I'm looking for. Either it's gonna find me or,
Hey, what the fuck are you doing with my property?
Hey, I'm trying to
get
camp out, man.
Get the fuck
man.
Off my
hey,
property. Don't make me get my gun. Get the fuck
a
off
gun?
My property.
That gonna make you,
you
feel like
a
man,
piece
dude?
Of me? You
shoot
want
the
a
fucking homeless
piece of
guy.
Me? Get the fuck off my property.
Alright, bro. I'm out of here.
You hear that diarrhea is hereditary? Because it runs in your genes. Blammo! Ned Harvey.
What's your name?
I'll take the usual.
Oh, I remember you, that Jack and Coke guy, right?
Bingo.
Right on.
All right, thank you guys so much for coming. So what's in the news today? How about those clowns in Washington? What a bunch of clowns, right?
Is tonight?
No, thanks. A little light on the funds.
Do you like this guy? He does open mic night every week. He does some comedy. I wish more people would do that instead of pretending to be like musicians.
Yeah? Do you get anything for going up there?
Anything like applause or tips?
Not like money.
No, man. It's an open mic form type of thing. Tell you what. You go up there, we do the whole special.
Okay, right on. What's the fruit net this week?
Someone, I think it was, maybe it was you, suggested I try cantaloupe. It's actually been a pretty big hit.
Yeah, right on. I'll tell you what, since I suggested it, how about you give me a free drink, and then another one for going up.
One before, another be any good?
Yeah, I got nothing to lose.
All right.
Force them to have sex with me. Lamo!
you guys have been a great audience. I'm just going to go ahead and take my time now. I'm going to introduce Steven, really funny guy. You guys can check me out, mattharveycomedy.com/78B3&comedy/MattHarvey.com. Woo! All right, so let's bring Steven up here.
Steven! Yay!
All right. Oh, he's a little taller. So, some pretty funny stuff's been going on in my life lately, like, I guess I found out it's hard to fish with your bare hands, even if it is out of a small fountain with huge goldfish. Okay, well, I got a joke for ya.
Just tell us the joke, don't announce it.
Right, so, what are Walter White's favorite kind of jokes? Knock knock jokes, because he's the one who knocks.
Ooh.
Oh, really? Okay, so there's a young boy and a child predator in the woods.
Was it you?
So, they're in the woods, and the young boy asks the older man, or he says to him rather, it's pretty spooky out here, and which to he replies, you have no idea, I have to walk out of here by myself later.
Did he rape and kill that kid?
Yeah?
Was it you?
No, it's a joke!
This guy's pretty funny.
Well, you know, something I have taken for granted my whole life, toilet paper.
Delivery could use a little work, but not that bad.
You've earned it, my man.
Cheers. Well, thanks for that.
No problem.
So, what was up with that guy you were here with earlier? Where's Darren?
Oh, Darren and I broke up a little while ago.
Start of year, though.
Yeah, it was inevitable. Nothing to do with you, though.
Well, I mean, but you moved all the way up here for
him. Well, I like it here. Don't tell anybody, though. But to answer your question from before, that was Elrond.
Elrond? Hubbard? The comedian?
How many Elrons do you know?
Well, where did he go?
Matt, the comedian? You went out with him.
That Goldilocks-haired motherfucker?
Yeah.
Is he kind of...
No, I think he's just trying to get an in on the industry.
Well, at any rate, you should have introduced me earlier.
I just didn't think of it, I'm sorry.
Ah, don't worry about it. So, where are you up to these days?
You know, I'm just kind of drifting around, kind of like you, but... I guess I'm floating about the water, using your hands to the barnacles.
That's one way you can put it. I should have offered you this drink to, you know, pay you back from earlier.
Forget about it. I already have.
The champs have arrived!
Yes! Yeah.
Yeah.
Woo!
Yeah! Let's go, baby! Woo! Yes!
That looks like my cue to me.
Oh, alright, well, where are we going?
Oh, no, you stay.
Oh, come on, the night's young, we can go.
Well, I'm sure I'll see you around. I left something with the bartender for you.
Oh, well, okay, thanks. Happy night.
You too.
You got something for me?
All right, I got that envelope for you.
Thanks. Can I use your phone?
Actually, it doesn't reach over there, but you can use this. Local call.
It is so nice not to suck ass in life.
I love it.
It's a fantastic game. It's an absolute...
Oh!
One!
One winner.
That's us.
Woo!
MVP, man.
MVP.
That's it. Show up. Help out. Make sure you guys steal the win.
And then you put that goal right into that dude's face.
Freaking deserve it.
Right in his face. Shot literally into his face and he fell in that. Alright. Steven, I left my girlfriend's yoga class early. What's up?
Yeah! Woo! There it is. Six, baby!
Six. Right on the mic. That's how many goals we put up their asses. Right up. God damn it. I don't want to be around these assholes.
Well, look, man. You're right. Bonneville did join their team.
The usual.
Moot is every much a piece of shit as you said he was.
Uh-huh. I didn't need to be reminded of that.
No, you don't need to be reminded, but you need to do something about it.
What are you doing?
Steven! Nice. Oh!
There it is.
Woo!
Oh, Jeff, I'm scared. Oh, hey. Steven, what the fuck are you doing here? I remember either of you guys being the game where I fought Bonneville over here. Yeah, pretty funny how things just worked out. You got traded to your team, right? Listen, man. Fuck you! You don't know anything about my league. You're not even in it. You don't know how it works, okay?
The other team's captain has to approve the trip.
Oh, and I bet he was thrilled about it. Okay, so you're all mad about a league you're not even a part of. Oh, big deal. Now you're gonna assault me in a bar because of it? How are you laughing at? You think that was assault?
All you out! I'm calling the cops.
Enough! We're gonna sell this like men. Oh!
Are you freaking kidding me?
Come on, guys.
You're all banned!
Shit, I was ready for an early night and I gotta clean all this shit.
Trashy hobos?
Yeah, I'm not afraid of shit.
Clark, reach behind me and grab those weapons we don't brandish.
Bonneville?
The gun, sir.
I don't know what you think you're doing, but if you take one step...
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Blast me.
I don't...
Oh shit, man, this has gone way out of hand. Look, it wasn't supposed to go down.
That pushed me in front of Ivan's dart. How fun cleaning up those pissy, shitty underpants.
Fucking fake gun? You know, you guys are fucking perfect for each other. I'm out of here.
Yeah, you best get going. And don't you ever come back. I don't want you disrupting my pure way of living.
What a tame.
Come on, it's me, Darren. You don't need to peek through the curtain.
What makes you think I'm a curtain peeper?
Please.
Yeah?
Are you gonna let me in?
Hey, I threw my flannel in your washing machine. It was getting kind of stinky.
You could put this one in there, too.
I don't know. Not that bad. Nice. Nice. See, you snagged it. I'm proud of you. Wasn't sure if you were going to do it. Didn't get the big one.
What? What? Spit it out.
Shh. Hey, Vivian's sleeping, all right?
You, big deal. Like, what? Why didn't you grab the big trophy?
It's a dumb superstition. You wouldn't understand. Like, they say if you touch the trophy, you're never gonna win it.
Seriously? If you weren't gonna win that trophy anyway, like, whether you touch it or not, I mean, unless you put Moo on your team, maybe. Get real.
I don't know, I just thought maybe stars would align and maybe I'd win for a change.
Not so much, my friend. But fuck those guys, you know, seriously. Fuck them.
You want some?
Wine? What am I on a fucking date with you? No, I don't want some wine.
I just figured I'd ask. Jesus.
So, what are you planning on doing with it?
I was hoping you would know.
I mean, I know a pawn shop down the road. We can probably get $15 for it.
Yeah. Yeah.
I mean, they're gonna find out you took it sooner or later.
Yeah. Hey, Steven. Can I ask you a question?
Dude, I hate it when people do that.
Do what? Ask you questions?
No, ask to ask a question. You're asking the question. Just, like, spit it out, dude. Just ask a question. Don't ask me to ask a question. Then you're asking two questions.
All right, forget it.
But, dude, you're like a fucking woman. Spit it out. Like, what's wrong?
All right. Steven, I noticed it when we were kids. Or I think I did. And I thought I saw it when we were playing hockey the other day. But that night, I definitely saw it.
No, I know what you're about to say, and no, sorry.
Alright, I don't want to come off as insensitive or anything, and if I do it, that's my bad, but you have some kind of psychosis or something where you talk to yourself.
You know, man, I don't know, it might be one of those things that's gone undiagnosed or something, maybe, I don't know. When I was a kid, I had this crazy dream that, like, aliens were monitoring me and, like, videotaping me secretly just to see how, I don't know, human society worked, and then one day they told me that they wanted more of an insight as to how I was thinking and the thought process behind it all, so I kind of just started announcing things out loud as to what I was doing, that way they could, you know, better monitor me.
So you think you're talking to aliens?
Give me some credit. No. I mean, I know I'm not obviously being constantly monitored by aliens. I was a dumbass kid then, but it's just sort of an old habit that stuck.
It's not like it's hurting anybody per se. It's just, it's not going to help you get ahead in life.
I never asked for help getting ahead in life.
I didn't mean any offense by it.
Look, it's just, it's none of your concern. This is your concern, alright? I would be surprised if they threw a brick through your window tonight because they were so mad at you.
Do you think they would do that?
They're probably out in their car right now, tying a little note to a brick,
making it all angry. They're gonna hum it right through.
You said you weren't a window peeker.
What am I gonna do, Steven?
Alright, here's what you do. You call them. Tell them I have the trophy. But you don't know where I am. Tell them you'll get a hold of me and you'll get it back for them.
I don't know. What if what if they come and take me and Vivian hostage?
They're not gonna throw a brick through your window, so why would they come kidnap you? Take you hostage. This isn't even the championship trophy. You grabbed the MVP trophy because you're too much of a chump to take the right trophy. They're definitely not going to do anything like that.
Where are you going?
I'll be back tomorrow. I have a plan. Sleep tight. Wow, nice house, Elise.
Steven, it's about time you showed up. We were expecting you last night.
Last night?
My favorite!
Well, I'm glad you like them. So, Elrond, is this your house?
Ha! I wish I lived in a place like this.
Alright, Matt, your house?
It's the funniest thing I've heard you say.
Before you say something even dumber than you already have.
This place belongs to a friend of a friend. I'll be here for another day or two.
Okay, what's going on? What's happening?
Can we talk alone for a moment?
Only if you bag it, am I right? Blammo! Not helping the cause. You guys just go ahead and do what you gotta do.
It's funny, after you left me in Darren's place, I never thought I'd see you again. And then I saw you last night, and I got you this address, and... well... here you are.
And here I am. I guess I have to ask you the question, why am I here?
Well, what are you doing?
Well, you made a face like you wanted to kiss me, like the girls on TV do.
I don't know what your perspective is of girls kissing on TV is, but I think it's warped.
Okay, well, we've established I'm not here to kiss you, so why am I here?
You know how I said the other day that Matt took Elrond out for like a little date, and he was trying to get an in on the industry, and... well, I thought maybe Elrond was going to ask Matt out on the tour... but he's already really annoyed with them.
So am I here to, like, be a duff and make Matt look better by comparison?
Well, I don't know what compelled you to get on that stage yesterday.
Free booze.
But you really impressed him. He liked your stuff.
So what are you getting at?
Well, do I really have to spell it out for you?
Why do you feel the need to help me?
You're a funny guy. You've just been dealt a bad hand.
Look, I appreciate it, but I don't think I need help getting a better hand.
Maybe you don't, but maybe you're the guy who complained last night that I didn't introduce him to Elrond. And maybe he needs a little help. And you're the guy to do it.
Maybe, but... I know one thing. I don't know what your relationship with Elrond is, but I'm gonna get that kiss.
So, like, you live on the street? Like, how do you brush your teeth?
All right, guys, who wants to play a game?
Oh, definitely. I'm down. Let's do it.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Come on.
Eh.
It's like charades.
Well, what do you do?
You pick a topic, and then you act it out.
And you guys have to, like, guess what I'm doing?
No. Yeah, let's do that.
Yeah, sure.
All right.
Good try.
So I'll go first. I like doing this stuff. Yeah, this is a good one. I got this. Johnson, could you step into my office, please? Now, I hate small talk, but I always like to get it over quick when I'm firing somebody. You should see your face right now, Johnson. I'm not firing you. The board of directors is. You shouldn't jerk off when you're at work. You should, you know, be like me. I've been jerking off throughout this entire meeting, and doing it discreetly. You have no idea. Get the fuck out of my office, Johnson. And scene. Any guesses?
I don't know.
Irony? Hypocrisy?
No, it's firing somebody.
So let me get this straight. You have to convey that you're firing somebody, and we have to guess that you're doing that. The only irony I see in that is that you clearly know what the word discreetly is since you used it in your little play there, but you don't know how to apply it in real life.
Steven gets it.
Yeah. You know what? Give me a turn. Let me go. Okay, I don't know how to do this one without being too obvious, but give it a shot. You know what? You might not be my son, but you're my nephew, damn it, and I know what goes on down at the damn Tashi station, and it has nothing to do with converters. I am here day in and day out busting my ass on this farm to pay my taxes, and you want to go down there and be a little harlot monger with all these women at the Tashi station? Join the rebellion? You talk about all this crap? I know what goes on. You want to go down there and join the rebellion and be with all these women and raise my taxes, then go ahead and do it. But I'll tell you what, boy, I will fucking smack some shit into you.
I don't think they talked that way during the Civil War.
Man, Uncle Owen must have been a real prick to Luke. So is this Star Wars from a minor character's perspective?
Ugh, close enough. R-rated Star Wars.
Close enough.
Oh, my turn again. Let's do it.
No, you guys. I'm gonna head out.
Really?
Yeah, I gotta take care of some stuff.
Okay.
So,
if you need to talk to me and Elise, here you go.
Oh, how professional.
Bye.
Bye now.
Bye.
Y'all come back
bye.
Now, you
come
hear?
See us. Southern Mississippi Pie.
I forgot to check the date, but, you know, whatever. If anybody was ever listening to these recordings would inevitably be time-stamped. Yeah, there have been times where I believed that nobody was important to me, that I was important to nobody. There have been times where that was no doubt proven to me, but, you know, right now is not one of those times. There are some things that people think are worth fighting for, and some things that aren't worth fighting for, but I've never really been much of a fighter, except when it comes to my folks. Yeah, you know, I'm not a big fan of trying to determine what's right and what's wrong, but all I know is that people get what's coming to them in the end.
Some second thoughts about this.
Come on, man, I got this. Alright, you stop right there. I give this trophy a little pull, alright?
What is this? You guys said on the phone you were having us here to give it back to us.
Look, before you start, you know, citing me on cruelty to trophies. Let me just tell you this. I don't give a shit one way about this trophy. If I pull it and damage it, it doesn't affect me. You guys can take it home later and fucking circle jerk around it all you want. Power to you.
Then give it to us, you piece of shit.
Whoa, man, calm down, all right? I'm getting to that part.
What do you want? You know, why are we here?
Well, you know, I got a little proposal for you, a little wager. If you agree to partake in this wager, I'll give you your trophy back. If not, I give a little ropey here a tug. Dude, calm down, all right? Here's my proposal. You three and that goalie that Darren says lives down the street versus the four of us in a little three-round shootout.
And if we win, we get the trophy.
Look, pay attention, guys. You get the trophy back whether you win or lose, all right? What if you win? Me and Darren here will pay for a professional documentarian to make an episodic series of your league.
Not a bad idea at all. I'm surprised I didn't think of that.
And if we lose?
All right, if you lose, Moo here has to relinquish his title of commissioner to me.
Steven, you're out of your damn mind.
I've seen these guys fight before. I'm not afraid.
Oh, think about the cup, man. The cup's bigger than all of this.
So what's it gonna be? You in?
Hang on.
Right now, the stakes are high, but this should be a slam dunk.
This guy's a joke in net. We got this down.
Break!
Skates or shoes?
Player's choice. Alright, look man, call that goalie. We don't have all day, alright?
Ivan.
I'm on it.
Dude, you got your trophy.
Why not just leave now? Who cares about that wager?
You know what, Kev? That's a good, rational point. Normally, I'd say it's about honor and living up to our word, but...
But I really want that documentary, don't you?
Alright.
Alright, so we just need you to make a few saves, and we're good to go.
Darren, this equipment smells like a rotten pile of shit, dude. I thought I smelt bad. How does this take the cake on that, man?
It hasn't really changed since last time. Same gear.
I don't know. I think it may be a little worse.
All right, so just make a couple saves and we got this, all right? Nice and easy.
Okay, I'll do my best, bud.
Yes!
Here I come, bitch.
Oh! For fuck's sake!
Did I actually block that?
You got this, Pip. You got this. Come on.
Hey, she didn't even check if the goalie was ready.
Dude, man, he was ready. She beat his ass. You know it. Get over it.
Joe, it's all right. Just get this one back.
I don't at least know us here.
Oh, man, I was not ready. Come on.
All right, my bad. I'll just have to retake the shot.
Whoa, you can't do that. You went in illegally. You missed the shot. We declined the penalty.
You can't do that.
Rule 138, Section 3, Part B. Clear as day.
All right, well, that's going to have to be amended next season.
That'll have to go through whoever the commissioner is, eh?
All right, goalie ready?
All right, you got this. Go, go, go.
Willow, sweet chariot, coming for the carry home.
Do what you do best.
You ready to throw that stick at me again? Just remember, we didn't last time.
Stuff him like a Thanksgiving turkey, and we got this, all right?
Yeah!
Yes!
There's some good eating in here.
All right, so overtime, pretty simple. Each team gets a shot, and if one team has a lead after a round is done, it's over. That team wins. If not, we do additional rounds until one team has a lead afterwards. All right? Pretty easy.
Alright, bury him.
Got this.
Look, he bites on almost everything, so just try to deke him again. But don't worry, he's also kind of weak up high, so.
Use your can.
Dude, you want me to take this one?
No, I got this. This ends here.
Mm.
Oh, come on!
Dude, don't even worry about that. You got this, all right?
Steven, just make a save and we win.
Ready? Hurry up, motherfucker.
Actually go through that bullshit.
I'm a man of my word. I'm sure Derek can get you a list of the 50 or so names you'll need to contact each week. But while you're at it, go ahead and scratch my name.
No way. You sore losing piece of shit. You know what? Scratch my name off that list too.
You see, I'll be starting a new league, which most of the players of this league will jump over to my league.
You know, I can't really say I'm shocked. I mean, I don't really want to be commissioner of any league anyway. Hey, Leroy, what's that machine that Clark has that trophy hovering over?
Wood chipper!
Hey, who went into my car?
Yeah, that's right. Hey, Leroy, call up Clark. Tell him to fire up that wood chipper and Fargo the shit out of that trophy.
No, no, please, 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 don't do it. We'll work something out. We'll figure it out. We'll figure it out.
Make the call, Leroy.
No, no, please. I beg of you. That trophy's all I have in my life.
Hey, Vivian, you got that?
Already posted it to social media.
Good. You know what, Moo? The trophy's sitting right behind your car. It's not going in a wood chipper. I just want to see you cry like a little bitch.
We're done here.
You're out of the lead. No shit.
I just want to play hockey.
Steven, my man.
Good job, man. Know you had it in ya.
Alright, so the shootout didn't go exactly as you planned it, but worked out.
Hey, whatever, dude. Beat him.
Got that video of that clown.
Good.
Things in my place?
Can I borrow your phone, though? I need to make a phone call.
Sure, yeah. Let's go over to the car. You can make a call while I'm changing out of the gear.
Cool.
Alright. Hey, Vivian, you coming?
I'll be right there.
I lived up to my end of the bargain. Now it's your turn.
Meet me at the porta potty. Make it quick.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that made a wretch like me.
I've always wanted to know what the hobo rape house is like. Is this where you keep the dead bodies?
What is up with you and rape in the woods?
I don't know, I've seen too many movies as a kid and they always make me laugh.
Tell you what, if you really want to see the hobo rape path, I'll bring you to it later.
Alright, alright, alright. Well, hey, that was a really nice thing you did for Darren the other day.
Someone had to put those dicks in their place.
It was really good to see him that happy, though.
So what, are you not a fan of his new girlfriend?
I think you're reading way too into what I'm saying.
So you're okay with it?
It was a mutual breakup. We met at the right time for you here. Didn't work for us as a couple, but it worked for me as an individual.
Yeah?
Yeah, I'm still here, aren't I?
I mean, I'm still here, so what? Like, that doesn't mean anything.
That's where I disagree with you, Steven. You know he's gonna offer you to go on tour with him.
What?
Yeah, he really liked your stuff.
What stuff? I didn't even tell any jokes. What about Matt?
Who cares? He said that you have the right stuff, whatever that means. But he really wants you to go with him.
So he wants me to go around and just go on tour with him across the country?
Yeah, you'll probably just be opening for him and staying in shitty little hotels while you play at shitty little clubs. But it could be the start of something so much bigger.
Yeah, I mean, that doesn't really sound like such a bad gig.
You're in no position to say no.
People have been telling me that my whole life, and, you know, I usually try and prove them wrong, but I think I should just accept it this time and go with it.
Hey, that's what I've been waiting to hear.
I think that's about half what you wanted to hear. So, what do you plan on doing?
I don't know, I'm just gonna do what I need to do to float above water.
You realize that's a pretty redundant expression, right?
So maybe Elrond's gonna give you some of those jokes that I wrote him that were rejected. Just keep in touch and let me know which ones.
I don't know.
No?
Well, I mean, you'll be checking into those hotel rooms right next to me anyway, so, you know?
You know, you have a really indirect way of asking people out.
So it's a yes?
No, that's not a yes. Dude, why don't you brush and shower, and then we'll do this again later.
I mean, I guess.
So, I don't really remember who, but someone once told me that you can only masturbate so much. And for quite a while, I thought that was true. But after going to enough shitty hotels, self-satisfaction just kind of turns into ritual. And I realized that ritual is what makes the world go round. Pattern, repetition, cycles, everything's bound to repeat itself. And the whole trick to life is just knowing how to deal with it, and maybe knowing when the cycle's gonna stop temporarily. But, I don't know, I could be aimless in life still, I guess. But as long as I'm enjoying it, that's all that counts, right?
That whole masturbation thing, that's just a metaphor for life, right?
Yeah, let's go with that.
Well, knock him dead tonight. Good luck.
Hey, thanks for having me tonight. The very funny L. Ron Hubbard will be up shortly. Until then, you get jokes about rape and hobo sex.
Is that correct?
Correct.
Okay, so we're starting with one. Here we go.
Man, Uncle Ben must have been a real prick to Luke. I mean, are all the minor Star Wars characters perspectives like that?
Cut.
Shit.
I'm gonna be with him. I'm sorry.
Alright. Oh, okay. So you're on Matt.
God, no, that's not
true. Am I supposed to say something right now?
You thought that was assault?
Oh, come on, man!
Enough! We're gonna sell this like that! Oh!
Steven! We were finding you. It's about time you showed up. We were expecting you last night.
Well,
my
favorites!
Well, you know what? I'm gonna tell you what I told everybody else.
You don't have to buy me a drink.
Of course I want to. I don't know. Delivery wasn't...
Aw,
oh, shit. Start over.
Ah, shit. Oh, well.
I think I'm supposed to say something here, but I don't know what it is.
Man, Luke. No wonder Uncle Owen must have been a real prick to Luke. I wonder if all the minor Star Wars characters are like that.
Cut. Well, fuck.
That was my fault.
Why do you feel you need to help me get a better hand?
I don't feel like I need to help you get a better hand. I don't really know what my line is. I already fucked up. Can we start over?
That's what you laughing at.
Shit, I was ready for an early night, now I gotta stay up and clean all this shit.
You think that was assault?
Hey, mother dick! What's your deal? Are you ready to take your sorries out of your sorry sack? Mother dick! Are you ready to take your sorries out of your sorry sack? Mother dick! Are you ready to take your sorries out of the sorry sack? Mother dick! sorries out of the sorry
sack? Hey,
mother dick! Are you ready to get your sorries out of the
sorry sack? Hey, hey!
Mother dick! Are you ready to take your sorries out of the sorry sack? Mother dick! Are you ready to take your sorries out of your sorry sack? Mother dick! Are you trying to take your sorries out of the sorry sack?
Look,
man.
What are you talking about there? Get out of there!
So I wonder if all the minor stars
are action.
Alright, let's go change. Let's go change. Let's change together.
Low budget earthquake.
Alright, say it a little bit louder.
Kevin, tilt your head to the other way.
Alright, ready? Action.
Tilt your head the other way, because the hat is directly blocking the camera.
Kevin,
tilt your head back.
Yeah, yeah, rub your face too. Ready? And action. Try it one more time. Be aware.
Did exactly the same thing. You have to look towards the cameras lately.
Bring your head back.
Like, yeah.
We were discussing that you'd probably take the money and you would probably take it for yourself.
I gotta clean all this shit.
Generation. Absolutely. Right. I like winning trophies on trophies. That's what we're all about. That's what you're Drake for days. That's what it's all about. Mm-hmm. Remember that guy I put right to the side, and then you freaking crotch shot him?
Yeah,
just
man.
Just like that.
You guys just go ahead and do what you gotta do. Go.
Is Matt Hubbard took him out?
Matt Hubbard, the that goalie lost him?
Camera two.
So this is the place I was talking about.
Where did he go?
He went out with Matt Hubbard. Oh shit, what are you doing?
Pardon me.
Oh my.
Steven, it's about time you showed up. We were expecting you last night. My favorites!
My name is
Matt.
Yeah,
you hear me?
All right, all right.
Why do you need to deal me a better hand?
I don't know. I really fucked up the line before this.
So.
That's why Steve and Leroy are friends.
Those time goals. Wait, I'm sorry.
Cut. So is that all the minor Star Wars characters?
Cut.
Look what we have here.
Man, Uncle Owen must have been a real prick to Luke. So are all minor Star Wars?
Cut.
Good resolution.
I don't have.
Get out of here! Now we both have blood upon our hands.
Well, you made it sound so simple. Uncle Ben must have been a real prick to Luke. All the minor Star Wars characters?
Cut, cut, cut.
So I wonder if all of these
cut.
You know, man, Uncle Ben must have been
it's
a real...
Hey,
what the fuck are you doing in my property?
Hey,
what are you doing in my property?
Trying to camp
get
out,
the fuck
bro.
Out of here, dude. Fucking screw.
Settle down, man.
Screw, don't make me get my gun. You want a piece of me?
You're gonna get, that's gonna make you feel like a man. That's gonna make you feel like a man shooting me, an unarmed fucking homeless dude.
This bug you?
All right, I'm out of here, bro. I'm out of here. Sorry, I'll get out.